So we need to. Okay, good evening, everyone. We are starting the meeting now. We are starting the training on how to navigate your back office. Sorry, people on Facebook, I don't really know how to join and connect Facebook to the screen. If I do, I'll be able to be doing what I'm doing now. So please let us just bear with me. So we as we start now. So now, like I said, now that we are actually going to learn how to master the navigating our back office, which is very key and very important, because if you are doing this business and you do not know how to master your back office, you have not started. So that one is very, very key. So this is what the training is about. So people on Facebook, just pick up what you can from what I say. But what is it called now? But the people that are in the Zoom, there's enough space in the Zoom. If you actually join, because I send the invite link even to Facebook and everywhere. So you can see join the Zoom meeting. There's more than enough space for you to take. So I'm going to at this time go to share. So I just hope that this will not give us any issue today again. Because I just saw yesterday's Zoom and I saw that it didn't really do what I wanted. So once again, everybody, you're welcome. So I will start from here before we go to the practical. Now, this meeting, my name is Omolara Nwabuze. I'm also known as Yabode Omolara Nwabuze, depending on what you desire to call me. But generally, I just tell them that my name is Omolara Nwabuze. Now, most of you know me by. Now, we are going to be talking about mastering your Long Beach e-commerce space, also known as your back office. So we are going to learn how to navigate our back office. That's what the teaching is about. Now, at this time, you need to understand that it is very, very key that you know how to operate your back office. That is very, very key. So don't let anybody deceive you. This is the only thing that can actually help you to master this business. That is just the truth of the matter. It is the core of your business. It is where you are in control of your business. Now, if whether people are coming, if people try and reduce the noise, whether you are signing up people, whatever you are doing, your back office is where your business is done. That what tells you what and what you do at any point in time. So it is very, very key that you learn to master it. So this is the login page for your business. And it is also popularly called your back office. And this is where you monitor the progress of your business, like I said, and everything about your business can be assessed through this page, as you are going to see during practical examples. So it's crucial for you to learn how to navigate this space for success in your business. It is the pivot for your activities in relation to your business. Jude, please, let us reduce the noise, please. I'm doing a class, please. Let's reduce the noise, please. So first things first, you must know the website where you can access your e-commerce page. It is known as www.longlikicn.cn. So longlikicn.cn. So that website, please don't forget it. If you go to www.longreach.com, that will just go to the website of the company. But this one goes to your back office. So don't forget it. www.longlikicn.cn. So when you click on it, this is what it brings for you. I'm going to do practical example of it as we go on. So this is what it's going to bring for you. It brings on this login page. That's the first thing that you see. Now, let's take the login page one by one. There are about three or four steps you have to take for you to access your back office. Now, the first line of this e-commerce page is you are asked to put your username or your user number, and that is your registration code. That is your registration code that you put there. So that first page is put as is for your registration code. So don't let us forget that and be putting something else. And for us in Nigeria, it means NG0, whatever it is, the number. Now, I have to say this here. the NG0, some of you go and put NGO, and you're not be saying the number is not working. It is not true. It is zero that follows NG. So don't let us turn it so that it is NGO. It is not NGO, it is NG0. So that one is key for us not to forget. Now, the next line, what you have there is the password. So you'll be asked to put in the password. Now, for the generic password for everybody, once your code is generated, is 123. That is the code for everybody. So don't forget that. But I always don't advise people change their code very early because you may forget. You may forget. So because I know a customer that I did the registration for, then he forgot. I had to be asking me how does, and I said, okay, send email to Longreach because I don't have access to that. So please don't change your code. Don't change your code except you you actually have so much money there that you are facing somebody will take. So that is just it. Otherwise, the generic code for everybody is 123. So when you maintain 123, you will not have problem with the code. So now there's an advanced password if you have problem, but I've never had to use it. I don't even know what to do with it. Now, then the next is the check code. Now, many of you get confused about this check code issue. The check code issue is that those string of four numbers by the side of the third line on the login page. Now, this one changes every time you are going back to access this code, this website, it changes. Every time you are going back to access the login page, it changes. Then if you have also left it for some time, maybe you actually click in the website and then it brings in the login page and you left it for quite a while, that code will not work again. So there's a limited time in which it works. So the code will not work again. So once you click it, you refresh and bring another code. So every time you want to access that login page, the code changes. Like you can see the one that is here now is 8639. That is the one I screenshot and put here for now. So don't let us forget that. Then the fourth thing that you will do is that you have what you call the login page. You have the next thing you will do now is the login page. So you when you now want to log in, you click on the button login, then it will take you to your website, to your login page. I mean to inside your back office. Let me see. Now when you are click on login, this is what you see. You see this space that comes before you, like you can see in the PPTX here. This is what comes to you. So the thing that you get is so the thing that it brings to you the announcement. Now, why this is very important is that anything the company wants to tell you, they're supposed to tell you using this feature. They're supposed to tell you using this announcement. So it is not as if you go about looking for rumors. And that's what they are going. They have a way they communicate with you. Any information they want to pass, whether there's promo, whether there's any change, because how many people would they be sending email to, or how many email would they be gathering? Many of us don't even put email in our registration. So this is where they communicate with you. So that's the first thing that comes to you. So that they just want that once you enter your back office, it's not as if that you start looking for information somewhere. You go straight there and then you are able to see where you are. Okay, so I think some people have already admitted the person. I don't know why the person is not yet able to come in. Okay, so like I've admitted him. I don't know what the issue is here. Okay, so like I was saying now, so that you get the right information from the company. So that is very important. Many of us don't bother to check until something is posted in the chat room. We don't check our back office. We don't check this announcement page. We should be checking it. We should be checking, and any message can be passed at any time. So at least, maybe if possible, check your back office in the morning, check in the afternoon, check in the evening if possible. So as much as you can, check and then be on top of your information. So it is very crucial that you don't go and be listening to gossips. You listen and check, you check your back office to get what information the company wants to pass to you. So this is what this is about. Now, let's look at the navigating your back office. Now, the first thing that you see on the extreme left corner is of the back at the top bar is the week. Like now we are in 2018. That's the week we are in now. And then we are also in cycle 5. So in this one, you see it's 2019-17, because that was the screenshot I used to prepare this note. So 2019-17, then cycle 5. Now the date is the next thing that you see there. The date ranges is like today now. Our this week business started yesterday, so it will be 2020-05-03. So that is when the week started yesterday, up to the Sunday date. So that is what those things represent. And then of course below you have the Longreach logo there. Now the next thing that you see that follows are what? So the other piece of information you see following are, you will see the flag of your country, you will see your name, then your code, and then the language. Like for us now, it is English. Then the help link, and then also the logout button. Now the logout button, at times you may be doing something you want to check, you want to put another code, you may need to log in or log out and all of that. So it is very important that you learn to do that. So you check that one, and then okay. So this late comers, you are distracting me. Okay, so then you have the logout button if you need it. So that is the only thing that you use to go out of the meeting, or you use to that takes you out, or that's what you allows you to refresh your page if you like. So now we want to go to the practical now. So now you need to understand one thing, that when you want to navigate your back office, you need to understand one thing. The left hand corner and the right hand corner of your back office. Now, every button that is meant for it to show you access to different parts of the back office, what you have on the left hand corner. So there are many things that are layered there. So we are going to see, and we are going practically now. There are many things that are layered on your left hand corner. Then on the right hand corner is the display dashboard. That way you see everything. When you click on that button, it shows everything, all the information that are there. That what you see that is shown there. From here, we go practically by doing live checking. So let's see now. So I'm going to go to a website. I'm going to go to a website now. So let me go to the website to do a practical. Now we are going to what's it called? I'm going to type in the. Please mute your mic when you enter. I'm the one talking now. When it's time for you to talk, I will let you know. So I'm going to take it step by step to see what we are talking about. So I'm going to type in the, okay. So I want to share again. Then I'm going to share the screen again. Okay. So I want to share the screen of the website now. Now I want you to follow me. So are you seeing my screen? Please, you can mute yourself and let me know. Are you seeing my screen? Are you screen the web? Are you screen the screen?
Yes.
Okay, so you are screen the Google screen. You are seeing the Google screen now.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, good. So you can mute yourself again. So now I'm going to type in You can mute yourself now, please. Mute yourself, everybody that is new there. So I'm typing the website now, www.longleaky.cn. Can you see that? Because I've actually been doing it before, so it is actually coming up in the memory of the computer. But then I want us to see it practically as I'm doing it. So can you see that now? So let's see what it brings up. Yeah. Wow. Okay, so can you see what I said now? Now, what are the check codes? Can you see the page that I'm showing? So somebody can answer me now. You can unmute yourself and answer me. The code, the numbers that are there. Can somebody tell me what numbers are there? Can anybody tell me?
6323.
Oh, good. Clap for yourself. That's good. Okay, good. So meet yourself now. So I'm going to use the code. Does somebody want to offer us their code? Are you thinking of using another code? Okay. So you see NG, then I'm going to put 0. You can see 0, then 4. So I'm going to use the code here. You can see it's a code I've used before. So that's the first thing. So it's the registration code I put in the first place. Now this one has already changed the password. So you're going to have 4 digits here rather than 3. Jude, please let me get fan from inside. Please give me a hit.
What?
Hand fan. Get hand fan for me. So I'm not going to put the check code. So 6323, you can see that what I put. So I'm not going to do the first thing. That's a login. Can you see that? Let's see. Can you see what I'm saying now? So what can you see? Who can tell us? What can you see? What can you see? Is anybody answering me? Can you see what can you see? What is the first thing that displayed on the screen now? Hello? Can you answer me, guys? Everybody mute your mic. Answer me or you mute your mic, please. Are you going to get the fan for me? Okay. Thank you. I don't like sitting on this side of the parlor. Hello, who is there? Is somebody asking me? What can you see on the display? Can you see?
You can see Long Ridge e-commerce system page.
What you are seeing now? What you are seeing now? Okay. They wrote e-commerce system. So you are seeing it. But what was the first thing that you saw there that strikes you as you get there? What was the first thing that I displayed on the dashboard? What the first thing I did on this dashboard?
Member system. Then we have announcement by Long Ridge
Nigeria. That's what I want you to see. You see, that's what I told you when I was using the screen, the screenshots. The first thing that comes, once you access your page, the first thing that comes to you is the announcement page. And I told you the importance of that is that the company communicates directly to you. And the company, the decision of the company, the company is going to do, they send it to you. They don't send somebody else to you. They send it to your back office. Then you know that is what the company is doing. So that is very, very important. Now you see here, when you look at the left side, and I told you the part of the left side here. So we're going to start and look at each of the buttons and what are hidden there. So the first thing that you see here now, you see, please mute your mic. Oh. Maybe this one. Now you see the message control. The first thing there is view announcement. That's the first thing, and that's why it is what is displaying. You can see that. Now the next thing, what's the next thing you see? Contact us. But like I have been saying, the message I've been sent from this place before, but it's like it doesn't work. So till now the message is still there. Nothing was done about it. Then the next one is maintenance management. I don't know what that means. So what's relevant to us actually is this first one. So that is the first thing that you see. That is that it's telling you what the company is doing at any point in time. So don't let us forget that. Now let's look at the next thing. Now the next button. What's the next button? Can somebody unmute and tell me? What's the next button I've clicked here? What's the next button I've clicked?
Membership.
Where?
Membership.
Membership. Good. Membership. membership. So now let us now be looking at each of them. We'll be looking at each of this membership. What is there? Now it is very, very important. This place, your business is very important if a membership. Your business is very important because that's where your PVs are placed. So it is very important you understand what you do with that space. Now the first thing is this. The first button under membership is what? Edit personal information. Now this gives you all the information that you need to know as a member. Now, maybe some of the other ones, I wouldn't really know, I've not tried to change mine, but maybe some of these other ones, you will see that you, what is it called now? It tells you everything about yourself. So if there's a mistake your stockist made when registering you, you can actually draw your attention to this. But I think you can edit up to this point. I don't know, but the one you cannot edit ever in your life is that of bank information. There is nothing you do. It's only the company that can do anything there. So that is, this one tells you who you are, your status, everything about you. So you can know from here what your status is. Now, the next thing, the next button tells you about search sponsor network. Now, this one shows you every single person that you have sponsored directly. Every person that you have a sponsor. I hope we know what you mean by sponsor. Now, it doesn't necessarily mean that the person you pay, but it's the person you referred to the business. Is that okay? It's the person you refer to the business. So, it is very important that you you also know that. At times, if somebody registered you and then you trust a stockist to register somewhere for you, and you don't know whether a person put you as a sponsor or not, you can find out from here. I told you there's no secret. Everything, every information about your business is inside this, your back office. So it is good that you master it and you understand it. Now then, the search placement. Now the placement, of course, okay, I forgot to say something. You can also know your generations of sponsors there. Now you can know, but people with really sponsor are usually your first generation. So that is why you see it here. But for placement, it's a different matter. Your first generation is really those three people that are directly under you. That are your first generation. So there you see that your three legs, who are the people under your three legs? That's where you will locate them. It is under this particular placement, search placement network. Now, it doesn't mean that you cannot find other people. If you do what you call this generation check now, you will see it will bring other people that are under this placement. They will bring under you. Okay, let me see. I don't know. This one is actually showing the people that are also their own three legs. So as you click on this arrow, it will be showing the three legs of all these people. So the three legs, where the three legs are not complete, it will not show the three legs there. So this is what you have under the placement tree. But that actually is not the issue here. But I told you the sponsor one is very important. And then this placement also, you can only have three legs. Now, of course, you can use it to check to know. Now, when you said the performance of sponsor network, now it will show you the PVs that are under this, your sponsorship tree. So let us see here, what it will bring here. So what this generation check is very key for you to check. You click on it, and then it brings for you the people that are under that your generation. It will show you. I don't know, let me check the internet, why it's not displaying. Okay, so let's go to the next one. Now, this place is very key. This placement of three performance. Now, depending on, it shows everybody in your generation, everybody that's under your tree is displayed here. Everybody. Now, depending on how many generations you want to check. If you want to check maybe just up to four generations of your placement tree, this will display it. So like I said, what you do is that, of course, this shows the week, then this is generation check. So now this will show only four generations for me, because that's what I ask it to show me. Only up to my fourth generation, you can see it's only up to my fourth generation that is showing. Now let me see, now it is also what is important here is this. The first column shows you as a member. I forgot to mention that when we actually first approached the tree. It shows your membership details. It shows the members there. Then the next level, it shows your entry level. So the next column shows your entry level. Then the third column shows the day you signed up. Now the fourth one shows the rank. Now it's very important that you understand there's a difference between rank, between rank and level. Now the level shows, whether you are a platinum, you are a VIP, you are a platinum, you are gold, or whether you are silver or Q silver, that is level. Now the fourth one, the rank is whether you are pre-diamond, which is even if you have up to 719 PVs, you are pre-diamond until you have 720 at least. So that's what makes you a diamond member. Now, from diamond one and above up to star director, this is where it will be listed for you. So this tells you, and this is for this person's tree. This is the person that owns this tree. So that's the person that is number one here. So you can see, but every other person, that the person has one generation, two generation, and four. Like I told you, I'm going to show only four. Now, if I decide to change this to maybe like 20, it will show up to 20 generation. So let's see again. You will see that it will show up to 20 generation. Our internet is quite slow. Okay, let me see. Let me click on it again. I don't know, our internet is slow, but let me continue with the columns. Now, see the new weekly upgrade order cell, upgrade order cell. The one that you are, that is bought under you for a particular week, it comes in this next. I mean that should be okay. So it has changed now to show everybody up to 20 generation. You have seen now it has changed up to the 20 generation, like we are seeing now. So you will see it from here. You see, before we have only four generation up to here, but you can see the generation 7 here. You can see up to 10 generation, 12. So I think you can see what I'm seeing. So all the generations that this person has are showing here. So because you asked for 20 generation. Okay, so let's go back to what we are talking about here. Okay, so now I'm talking about the upgrade, the weekly order. Now this shows any week that you buy, you do any PV. This is where it will show. Like here is doing 00 because there are no PV that have been bought this week. Anyway, you people know that we are not confirming PVs for now. Now this shows the accumulator upgrade order. So with this now you can know whether what is your rank. You can actually know, you can see these two now, where they are. So it shows that these people are VIPs because it's more than 1,680 that you need to become a VIP. So that means this person actually is a VIP. Now the new performer current week. Now for this week, so this we show here. This is what you do will have. Then this one will show the one of last week. Accumulated previous order perform placement tree for last week. So that will show here. It will show here what the total person has. Then the one of the, okay, no, of the performance order of the placement tree. Then that of the last week. Yes, I'm forgetting because we have not had a new order for this week. So this is what is the current week now. What this person has accumulated so far. Then we now have the new repeat order. Now the repeat order here for this cycle, now we know the one cycle ended yesterday. So for this cycle now, this person has 30. So until other people in the tree do, and then you see what the person has accumulated over the years in terms of the repeat cycle. That's enough for somebody to be a VIP anyway. Now the new repeat cycle order, then the accumulated one. Okay. Now, I don't know if you can see my screen because this is not allowing me, because your pictures in my screen is not allowing me to see the last place. But this one we see that I'm with green will show you everything you have plus your accumulated PV and everything. It will show you everything. I don't know. Please, is any of you seeing my screen? I'll meet yourself and tell me whether you can see where the green arrow is. Hello? You can see where yes. the CRM. Yeah, that shows your total PV, all the PVs that you have. That what that one will show. So that's how you know that everything that you have. But there's an important thing I also want us to show. Now, if you let me say that I move away from here now. Now, if I want to come back here. Now I'm coming back to placement tree performance. Now instead of putting end generation, if I just say check, you know what it will show me? The three people under me really. That's just my first generation. That's what it will show me. So at times for you to just check and know that, oh, where is your big leg? Where should you pay your PV? You can actually know it from here. So by the time you look at the accumulated performance of upgrade order, that's to show your rank. And then when you look at this PV now, okay, all the PV that you have. So far in your upgrade order, in your placement tree, this is where they are. Then you now you cannot say, okay, with this now. With this now, you cannot say, okay, that with this one that I have now, that I know where I need to place my PV. What is my big leg? What is my sharing leg? So with that, you can know. So that is the essence of, so at times I'm going to check. But why checking everybody? Why checking everybody is good? You know, the reason of why checking everybody is good is that it helps you. It helps you most times to actually know, what is it called now? So that one helps you to actually know if any member of your team has actually, what do you call it now? If any member of your team has graduated or moved up, and then the person may not know, as well as they don't know how to check their backup. It is key for you to learn to share your backup, and that's the point of this training. So that when you know how to check your back office now, it becomes easy for you without needing to wait for your upline. Now, so let's move to the next button. You can see this next button now. That shows you your tree. It shows you the tree in graphical form. So that one shows you then your three branches. Now, for you to know who and who is under you, there is always an arrow under each one. Then you will see the code, the name, the rank, then it will show the name, let me start with the first one. Let me start with the first arrow. Okay, so this will show, it will show the person's name, the code, the name, the level, then the rank, then the PV for that week, then the member, the total member the person has, we show. So all this information can be gotten here, but it's presented in a graphical form. So now if you want to see that, okay, how many people are under me, then you click. Of course, with that one I showed you before, you can actually know. But in a graphical manner, you can check this. You just click on the arrow. When you click on that arrow there, and you know the interesting thing also is that when you even click on this, it shows you also the earning. For that week, it can show you the earning for that week. So I can, God bless you. So it's good to be my mouth. They give me, sorry, oh, you guys cannot join me. My children gave me something here. Okay, so what am I saying now? That it shows you in graphical form. I can even show you, sorry, please, I hope you are assisting. It shows you in graphical forms the tree. What you, like if you this internet, you know what you call tree diagram. So that one is showing you. Now this will show you the person's rank and all of that, like I show. Then if you still want to go further, you just click on this. You see again now, it shows the next set of three people. So for each of the one that you have under you, you can actually get and check and know. At any point in time, you can do for everybody that's under you, every of the code that's under you. It is the same, excuse me, it's the same process. But let's see, interestingly, I think I have some. You can see this one is a one member, this one is two member, then this one is 10 members. So definitely, there are three, their own three from here now will be different. This one does not have anybody under, but this person has two people. Okay, but the two people said is on one leg. It's on one leg of the person. Then let's see now, let's go back to this one. And again, this person is also on one leg. This one has two legs. So at time when you start going down, it becomes like that because some people are actually not ready to do the work. So what do you do for such people? So by this helps, what the whole essence of this is that it helps you to know who is doing what under you. So let's go back again. So you can see now again, this person, you can see again, this person having all these people. So you need to understand this. At times to balance your leg. If you are putting all your PVs under one leg, you see, it can give you problem. But what you call leg balancing is when you're able to spread your PV, because for you to become a diamond four, you have to have two diamond three on two different legs. So this one, I think this is a whole new training. But the point is that when you understand how to manage this space, it helps you to know, oh, okay, so now I have one diamond two, then I need to hustle for another diamond two. Let's see this place now. Okay, you can see here now. Okay, there are two diamond two. Okay, to not make my point. I wanted to actually make a point to show somebody that probably is noise. Okay, let me see here now. This person has one diamond two and another diamond two under this diamond two. You see, another diamond two under this diamond two. But the person cannot become a diamond three because the two diamond twos are on the same leg. So a person cannot become a diamond three. So it's very important that you understand that you must have the diamond two on two different legs for it to work for you. So, and this is just the way it works. I wouldn't know what this Chinese thing is about. So I think, I don't know what it's for. So I don't think it's something that should bother us. So, but here is very, very key for us to know how to balance our legs. Very, very key. So you can see now this person already has the two diamond four on two different legs. Then you now begin to wonder. So here it may be the PB requirement that is remaining for the person to move to the next round. Now let us look at other management. Now, why it's very important to you, because some of you don't know, you can actually do your own order without needing to go to a stockist. If you know your stockist that you are using, you can actually hear from here. You can actually book for your order. You can actually book your order here. So you can do this. I think I will not do this for this place for upgrade because you can do it for fun. Now, if you click on add here, you see, so this is the stockist person I'll be using. So, but because I have a different stockist now, or let me say that I'm also a stockist, so I can change it to this. Then you now put all the other names that are necessary here. You put the person's name. You put the name and the state and everything. Okay, all the information will be there. But what you need here is the person's name. So when you put the name there, then of course this is the name. Then you can input it here. As you put it there, then the person can now add the order. So then you now go down here. And of course, we see now that they have removed super bling. You can see now that the super bling clean have been removed. Is only one that is remaining there, that of 650, I saw it yesterday. But you can see other products that are here. So you can decide to choose from any of these things. You click on it. Maybe you say that you are buying two. Then I think you are seeing the money adding up because the pictures are covering me again, like I said. So now when I click on that, then I now say submit. Okay, it's asking me to put all these names here. Okay, so I'm going to try and submit again. Okay, you see now it's telling me added successfully. Can you see that? So it has put it here because I've not paid. It says unpaid. So once I pay, the stockist can now. So when I pay a stockist, the stockist that can confirm my order. So I cannot confirm myself, except I have money in my back office. So I cannot confirm myself. So and that back office money actually is meant for repeat order, which I'm going to show us. So that means you can actually make your order and just send money to a stockist to help you confirm your order and pick up your products there. Can we understand that? Now, let's see repeat order. Now, repeat order, you can also do it yourself. Just go through the same process like I said. So this one now, you put your stockist. So you put your stockist here. Then it has brought the name of the stockist. Then I think, let me see. I think it's the name of the person that should be here now. Is the person's name. This one, a lot of highlight back. But anyway, for teaching purposes, so let us just do it. Then we now say that, okay, we circle. Okay, he's telling me there is an error. Okay, let me know about that. But just understand that one with the upgrade order. I don't want to touch it because when I want to do it, I want to do it for my stockies end. So, but when you put, okay, no, this one actually is not supposed to be, it's not supposed to be here, it should be here. I think that was a problem. So this one should be here. Somebody's day, this thing is see, oh no. So then you have to start putting all these details. I didn't know not a lot of wahala. Anyway, just understand what I said, that you can do this the way I did in upgrade order. Then you go down here and do your order. If you have money in the back office, then you can claim your order, you can put in your order, and then you put the stockist code that you want, and with that you can do your order. Now retail order, the same thing you do with upgrade order, you can actually also click on add. So now let me tell you the difference between repeat order and retail order. Repeat order, you do it with the money in your back office, in your e-wallet. If you have money in your e-wallet, you can use it to do this repeat order of 30 PV minimum. But somebody said that she actually did a small PV and the thing added up. And I have not tried that, so I wouldn't know. But somebody in our member said that she did that. So maybe I will also try that one day. That she has more money in her son's back order, then she now uses retail order to complete it, to do her 30 PV cycle purchase. Now, so retail order is the one you take money to the stockist to go and pay the stockist to do for you. So for your 30 PV minimum. Then you have, now these are the retail orders that have been done here. Now, if you want to know how far you have done your retail order, you can know here. Because like this person now actually buys in bulk, the retail order. So you buy a number of PV. You can see here now, I think this one should be about 150 PV. This one should be about 150. Like I said, I'm being covered by the my screen is covered with your this thing. So but if you want to know, you can now say inquire. If you click on the last button there, inquire the cycle of repeat. It will show you all the ones. So you see this one has been done up to cycle 8. And we're in cycle 5 now. So the person is still covered. That cycle 6 that has already become activated. So the person is still covered to cycle 8. And this is the best way to do this thing, because you not have anxiety over the the cycle has ended, you have not done your 30 PV. So you should be doing your 30 PV ahead if you can afford it. But if you cannot, no problem. Buy. Make sure that every cycle you buy your 30 PV. Finally, like the cycle 6 just started now, you can actually start. You can actually buy your 30 PV now, and you can actually buy your 30 PV now, and just make sure that you are ready before it will become stampeding at the end of the cycle. Now, let's see now. So I'm finishing with the order management. At any point you have any question, you can raise your hand, please, so that I can attend to your question. Any point you are confused. So let's go to commission. Now this is your earning. Now you see this week now, the payment, last payment was made for week 14. It was made for 2020-14. That when the payment that was made last Thursday was for. You know, we always get paid 3 weeks behind, for 3 weeks behind. So you see now then the member code, the member name, the level, and the rank. So that will follow. Then after that, what do you have next? You now have the development performance. You have development performance next. Then followed by retail order performance. So you can see the retail order is once in every cycle. Whereas the, so that I will tell you that do your retail order so that you can get paid. Now this one is of course 270. So you can see that it's those two people that did under this person. That one person is getting only 540. That is only one you get paid. This development performance bonus, that one is $6. And that one is seeing because the company uses 200 naira. That why you are seeing 1-2 here for development performance here. So every 60 PV give you that is done under you as added by you. Well, it doesn't matter your generation where it was done. You get paid this 1-2. Then this is your retail order performance bonus. So your own and whoever is under you that has done it. So you get paid for that. Then let's see the next one. It's Turkey's commission. I've never seen it here. Then you have the diamond VIP bonus performance. That one too is not here. So maybe it's for another system. Then you have the performance usual 8 card. It's not also here. So then you have the performance bonus, which is the one most of us are familiar with. That is the one that is based on your two bonus legs. That's the when you have PV on your two bonus legs, that's what you have, the performance bonus that you get there. Now, the importance of 30 PV is as a leader, as a diamond one and above, you get paid. You can see leadership bonus is more than performance bonus here. Can you see that? So when your downlines are anywhere, you get paid. You can see this person, this leadership bonus is greater than the performance bonus. So that's why it is important that you do your 30 PV. Now, if this person does not do 30 PV, you see the person will lose that money. The person will not have it. And then not only that, now this is the 5% that the company keeps for you, the repeat amount. This is one the company keeps for you. So the record is also here. That I'll show you where it is also kept within the system. Then the VIP point. You see the VIP point, and like we said, that why you need to become a VIP is that for you to earn, if once you earn up to 1 point, it becomes $100. That's the point that you get. It becomes $100. Then let's see now here that the VIP point also gets activated. This you have about 4 incentives. It's an international incentive. This one gets activated when you do your 30 PV. So you see why it's important that you do your 30 PV. This also is part of what you get activated, your earning. The point for travel. You start any travel point when you become a diamond 4. So you have start any this travel points. So then when you also get you start any travel points as a diamond 4. So that is very, very, but you cannot earn all these things. If you are not doing your 30 PV, you can't earn them. Now, the next thing is as a diamond 6, you earn car points. Again, that one, if you have 1 point, it is actually $100 again. Then as a diamond 7, you start earning your housing points again as a diamond 7. So that is very, very key that you actually go for your, your 30 PV, because this is what opens up to you. And then the last column, of course, in the last column, what you have, the total money that you earn for that week. So it will be put in your last column. So you see now that it's fluctuates depending on your activity. That will determine your earning. So that's the way it works. Now let's go to the next one, incentive point management. Attending point management. Now, this tells you that as your points are accumulating here, it's being recorded here. So, your points are being recorded here for VIP, for travel, for all this one are being recorded here. Then, you have also commission report. Now, here, so that one are actually in your main commission. So, but what is not there is the fast trip pack bonus. So you can see the fast trip pack bonus that this person has already collected. So this is where you have the record. So you can check it and you can see that. Then let's see now. Now the way you say your incentives, they have been calculated there, and this is where if you determine whether you take them or you keep them. So this is where you have the record being kept for you. So you can see how you are earning every month. So it is being added for you every month as you are earning them. Then what about the payments? Then we also have your, what's it called now? Be added here too. So your payment details. But I don't have anything here, so I wouldn't know. Maybe it's incentives payment here. I wouldn't know, but that is what is there. So let's look at the last one, not the last anyway, penultimate one, finance management. Now here, this is how you have the record of your 5% being kept. Your 5% is being kept here. So all the money you are in, you can see here now. Now you have the record there. Now this person has taken out only once to do repeat order. All the other ones have been deposited for the person. So you are having your deposit be your 5% of every month that you are earning every week being deposited here. And I always tell people, this one can actually tell you, give an idea what you have earned from Longreach. By the time you are able to calculate that, okay, this is 5%. Then you now say that, okay, 5% or 100%. Now that tells you the amount you have earned from Longreach. So it can give you an idea. If you don't have where you are recording it, so the company is keeping record for you. Then the last one is the system. Now here you say you can change your password. This way, if you want to change your password, this is where you go to. But like I said, I don't advise you touch this place until you are so sure it is necessary. But I doubt really if anybody can have access to your this thing, because there's no way somebody can go there. Because the person still wants to purchase something, you have to be in your code. They cannot use your money that is kept by the company to buy for any other person. It has to be in your code. So that's just the reality of it. But then once you have money coming into that system, it is wise that you change the password. So I don't know if we have any question. I'm not seeing many of us again. If you have any question, you can type it in. If you have question from Facebook, you can also type it in. I'll be glad to give you an answer now. So this is that about our back office. So let me see if we have any question that I want to ask now before we call it a day. Thank you so much for being here. Any question, you can mute your mic now and ask your question. Then you can type in your question too on the Facebook Live. You can type your question and we'll gladly answer. Any question? Any question, any confusion? Do we have any confusion? Is it clear now? Can we now navigate our back office without any trouble? Any question? Unmute yourself if you want to ask questions, please. You can unmute your mic now. Hello, are we still there? Okay, I want to take it that we understand that there's no problem. Is that so? I'm very glad about that. That's good. Thank you very much for coming. So this marks the end of the lesson today. So I expect that you should, after now, be able to navigate your back office, taking cognizance of all the buttons there on the left side and everything that you are doing on the display board. I will repeat again that why it is very important is that this is the only way you can actually control your business. You can actually manage it, because if you don't know that you are putting your PB on one leg, this way we tell you. If you don't know that why you are not earning, you can find out from your back office. When you're not earning, that means you are putting all your PBs on your sharing leg rather than on your bonus legs, because it is bonus legs that gets you paid inside this business. So that is why it is very important that you understand your back office. Thank you very much. It's nice having you here tonight. God bless you all. Let me check chat if anybody send any chat, because I don't know. Let me check chat. Okay, so there's no chat, so that's good. So, okay, God bless you. I'm going to end the meeting now. If there's no question. Yeah.